Good morning, Franklin Elementary. Here's your official 2020 virtual field day demonstration videos. Most of the items needed to complete this field day have been supplied by the Franklin Elementary, or FES PTO. However, not all of them are included. Feel free to be creative to utilize household objects for this field day. You'll notice I do the same thing in my video demonstrations. Finally, you'll notice in the demonstrations that I give varying distances for activities. As a general rule of thumb, pre-K to second graders should use the shorter of the options, and third through eighth graders should use the larger. But feel free to use whichever distance allows you to have the most fun. If you need to adjust any activities for your students to have more success, feel free. If you have any questions, don't hesitate to reach out to me on field day. Have fun! The first activity is called Backboard Bank It. You'll need one laundry basket, one wall, something you can place on the ground about 5 or 10 feet from the wall. This is what you're going to be throwing behind, and 5 tennis balls. I only have 3 tennis balls, so I'm going to use 2 pairs of rolled up socks as well. The goal of this game is to throw the socks or tennis balls, try to get them to bounce off the wall first and then land in the basket. The tennis balls or socks must bounce off the wall before going into the basket, or you do not get the point. Tennis balls or socks that bounce off the wall first, then stay in the basket, will earn 1 point. This is the only way that you can earn points. You have 1 minute to score as many points as you can. Don't forget to record your score on the official field day scorecard. Pro tip, rolled up socks are easier. Next activity is called bowl ball. To play bowl ball, you're going to need 3 different size bowls, a pair of rolled up socks, and something you can place on the ground 6 to 8 feet from the closest bowl. To play bowl ball, you're going to line your bowls up from largest to smallest in a straight line. The largest and closest bowl will be worth 1 point. The middle bowl will be worth 2 points, and the smallest, furthest bowl will be worth 3 points. You have 1 minute to score as many points as possible. The socks must land in and stay in the bowl to get the points. Next one is called Close Relay. You're going to need an oversized t-shirt, an oversized pair of shorts, and an oversized hat. You're going to set up 2 markers about 15 to 30 feet from each other. You pick 1 marker to serve as the start and finish line. That's going to be the same marker. The shorts should go by the start slash finish line, and the shirt and the hat should be placed by the other marker about 15 to 30 feet away. When the timer says go, you race from the start marker to the other cone. You put on the oversized t-shirt. Once the t-shirt is completely on, you race back to the start cone. You put on the shorts. Once the shorts are on completely, you race back to the other cone, put on the hat. Once the hat is on, you race through the finish line. Record your time on the official field day scorecard. up, we have the Coin Flip 400. All you need is a coin, your legs, and maybe someone to help you keep count. You start your timer and flip the coin. If it lands on heads, you run 20 steps in place. If it lands on tails, rest for 5 seconds, then flip again. You're trying to reach 400 steps total, but you only run when your coin lands on heads. Who can complete 400 steps the quickest? This activity is called Fan a War. This is one of the few activities you'll need to play against someone during virtual field day. For this, you're going to need 2 paper plates or school folders will work fine, and 1 balloon. You're going to mark a center line on your table and then start your timer for 1 minute. You and your opponent will use the paper plates to fan the balloon to your opponent's side of the table. If the balloon falls off the table, simply pick it up and start it in the middle again. When the 1 minute timer goes off, if the balloon is on your opponent's side, you win that round. Play 2 rounds of Fan of War, and if the score is tied after 2, have a 3rd tiebreaker. This one's called Flip Your Lid. You'll need a spatula and a plastic lid, or really anything you can flip. I'm going to be using this Tupperware lid. You can see that this is the top of the lid, and this is the bottom. To start, you're going to place your lid on the ground or table with the top facing up. Next, you're going to slide your spatula underneath it and flip it up into the air. If the lid lands with the top facing down, you earn 1 point. If the lid lands with the top facing up, like you started, you do not get any points. Once you see how your lid has landed, count your point or don't, and then flip again. How many points can you earn in 1 minute? This is one of my personal favorites. It's called If the Shoe Fits. For this activity, you're going to need 1 shoe and a whole lot of space. Seriously, go outside and get far away from anything that you might break. First, you're going to put your shoe on the tip of your toe. Next, you're going to kick it straight up into the air and wait for it to land and come to a complete stop. If your shoe lands on any of the sides, you earn 1 point. If your shoe lands right side up, you earn 2. And if your shoe lands upside down, you earn 3. After you count up your points for that flip, put your shoe back on your toe and flip it again. How many points can you score in 1 minute? This next activity is an oldie but a goodie. Keep it up. For this, you'll need the balloons provided in your field day goodie bag. You can start with 1 or as many as you'd like. Blow up the balloons and see how many times you can hit them up in the air without any of them touching the ground. If you're using multiple balloons and 1 touches the ground, you can no longer use that balloon for the rest of your time. How many times can you hit the balloons up in the air in 1 minute? This activity is called Look for the Goods. This is a scavenger hunt. Pre-K, kindergarten, first, and second grade students, you'll play Look for the Goods during your Zoom room time with Miss Christina and Nurse Sherry, so please don't play before then. After your Zoom room, if you'd like to retry Look for the Goods, feel free. In Look for the Goods, you'll have 1 minute to find each item. First, you'll want to select a home base. This can be a dining room table, a desk, outside, any central location. First, you'll be searching for something that starts with the letter L. Take up to 1 minute, find an item that starts with the letter L, and bring it back to your home base. Next, look for an item that begins with the letter F. Search for 1 minute, bring that item back to your home base. Then you're going to search for an item that starts with the letter T. You search for 1 minute and bring your T item back to your home base. And finally, you're going to search for anything that begins with the letter G. Take 1 minute, find something that starts with the letter G, and then write down all four items that you found on your official field day scorecard. Next activity is called Paper Plate Cornhole. You'll need 3 pieces of paper, which I've already made into paper airplanes. You'll need a laundry basket or a garbage can, and you'll need a marker you can put on the ground, something that you can throw behind. First, I'd like everyone to take a little time to research and design 3 paper airplanes. You can use any other supplies that you'd like to create these airplanes. I used paper, and I put a couple pieces of tape on the front and back just so they'll keep its shape when I'm throwing. You're allowed to use whatever you want. Just do me a favor and take some pictures so we can see how creative everybody got with their paper airplanes. Okay. Once you have your paper airplanes made, place a laundry basket about 5 or 10 steps away from the marker that you'll put on the ground. You'll have 1 minute to score as many points as possible. You earn 1 point for hitting the outside of the basket with the paper airplane. And you earn 2 points for making the plane inside of the basket. Once you throw all 3 of your paper airplanes, run over, pick them up, return to the throwing line, and throw again. How many points can you earn in 1 minute? This is another one of my favorite activities. It's called Penguin Race. To play Penguin Race, you're going to need 2 cups and 1 tennis ball or a pair of rolled up socks. To play, you're going to set up 2 cups on the ground so they're about 15 to 30 feet away from each other. Next, you're going to place the tennis ball in between your knees. When you start the timer, you need to waddle from 1 cup to the other with the ball between your knees and turn the cup over. Once the cup is turned over, you race back and flip the cup you started next to. See how many times you can flip the cups in 1 minute. Here's the catch though. If the ball falls from between your knees, you need to do 5 jumping jacks before you can pick up the tennis ball, put it back between your knees, and continue waddling on. Next up is the scavenger hunt. 3rd, 4th, 5th, 6th, 7th, and 8th grade students You'll be completing the scavenger hunt in your Zoom room with Miss Christina and Nurse Sherry, so please do not do the scavenger hunt before then. All other students, your parents may need to help you during this scavenger hunt because the list is a little bigger. The list of items has been printed out and placed into your field day goodie bag. Students will need to find one rock, one pine cone, one weed or flower, one stick, one item that begins with the letter B, one item that begins with the letter G, one item that begins with the letter M, one item that begins with the letter T, something orange, something brown, something purple, something pink, something that's a circle, something that's a triangle, and something that's a rectangle. Students will have up to 10 minutes to find as many items on the list as they can. After the 10 minutes is up, write down how many items you were able to find on your official scorecard and specify which items you were not able to find. This is another one of my favorite activities. It's called water bottle trap. For this, you'll need a water bottle or any sort of plastic bottle will work, a laundry basket, a tennis ball, and something you can place on the ground to throw behind. You can begin by leaning the basket on the water bottle like I have here. Next, place your marker on the ground about 8 to 10 steps away from the water bottle and the laundry basket. The goal is to roll the tennis ball so it knocks the basket off of the water bottle. You get 1 point if the basket falls and traps only the ball under the basket. You get 2 points if the basket falls and traps only the water bottle under the basket. And you get 3 points if the basket falls and traps both the tennis ball and the water bottle inside the basket. You have 1 minute to score as many points as possible. Last activity of Virtual Field Day 2020 is the water relay race. For this, you're going to need a large bucket filled with water. You're going to need a cup. You're going to need the largest plastic bowl that came with your goodie bag. You're going to need a couple markers you can place on the ground and possibly a bathing suit. You're going to start by placing the large bucket filled with water on the ground. This is going to be your starting point. About 15 to 20 feet away from the bucket of water, place the largest plastic bowl that came in your goodie bag on the ground. Place your markers 2 steps in front of that bowl that you just put down. When the timer says go, you're going to dip the cup into the large bucket of water and fill it up. Then you're going to place it on your head and then take your hands off. Try to balance the cup full of water on your head and walk to the other bowl on the ground. Once you get within that 2-step marker on the ground, you can use your hands again to take the cup off your head, dump it into the bowl, race back to the water bucket, fill up your cup again, put it on your head, hands off. Fill up the bowl with water so that it's filled to the very tippy top and is even overflowing. How quickly can you get that bowl filled all the way up? Hope you guys enjoyed Field Day 2020.